Down to 27 degrees, that's 84 degrees Fahrenheit. There's been a lunchtime storm and there's a breeze that I'm told is about 12 knots. Not what the Brazilians here playing in blue wanted, exactly what the Dutch would have prayed for. Team photograph, and for some like Koeman and Wouters, maybe their last appearance in a Dutch shirt, unless they get the victory. Two captains, Koeman and Dunga. The fact that Dunga is captain will tell you that Rai has not got his place back. The referee, Rodrigo Badia Seguera of Costa Rica. And the two linesmen, Yusuf Al-Khatan of Bahrain and Mohamed Fanaei of Iran. The yellow of the supporters of Brazil. Their team, as I said, playing in blue, and here's the man they have to beat, Ed De Hui. And the lineup in front of him will show just the one change, the return of Jan Wouters, who was suspended against the Republic of Ireland, and he and Rob Bitschke will form the left side in midfield and defence, and the man who loses his place is Frank de Boer. As for Brazil, they too make just one change. Branco at number six comes in place of the suspended Leonardo. Branco winning his 74th cap, but he hasn't played a competitive game for a month. An early test, I'm sure Dick Advocaat has asked from Mark Overmars. All the quarterfinals have their fascination here in the seventh largest city in the United States. We have the glamour. Romário and Bebeto wait. One of the keys will clearly be how well they are marked. Say it's Romário against Bergkamp. You could say it's Koeman against his club colleague Romário. It's the Brazilians of Europe, as the Dutch are often called, against the real McCoy. A Brazilian side suggesting it's the best since the World Cup in Spain in 1982. Jonk, who's played a major part in that, and Falux, an indication of the confidence in the Dutch camp. Both Falux and Winter volunteered to mark Romário. Here's Dunga. Adair. Marcio Santos. At the moment, it's Falux who's got the job of marking Romário. Trevor Brooker.
Yes, because they know each other very well. Used to be at Eindhoven, and good friends. I believe Felix went over for a summer holiday once in Brazil. And who's going to go off on holiday after this game, I don't know. But Holland, I think, delighted with the weather. Be interested to see how Overmars does with his pace against Branco down this right-hand flank. But I think, for me, the key area is in midfield, where I think Holland have the edge. And if they can get control there, they could get a surprise win.
Interesting that, unlike in practice yesterday, Wouters starting off on the right side. Jorginho, number 19, Van Fossen. Could be argued that the Dutch have absolutely nothing to lose in this one. If they go out to Brazil, no one will complain at home. They will have done well. Brazil always have everything to lose until they've finally won. Dunga. Behind the ball other than Bergkamp. Mazinho. Branco on the left touchline, fed by Marcio Santos. This is Mazinho. No foul. Bergkamp has his first run. Forced across. No foul. Get up, says the referee. Second free kick is given. And Rijkaard seems to want to make a point and is waved away by the official from Costa Rica.
Yes, I mean, there were a couple of tackles that went to let the Bergkamp on go, and then Rijkaard tried to make the point afterwards. That was the third tackle. But the referee hopefully is going to let the game flow. We tried to do that in the first couple. You mentioned Wouters. In fact, he's going to do a man-to-man marking job on Bebeto, and so that's unusual for him. Usually he does play midfield, but he's a man marking job today.
First chance for Branco at a free kick. Gives them an extra weapon. Never looking likely to keep that down these days. He plays for Fluminense, he's 30 years old. Played for Brescia, for Porto, and as Liverpool will remember, from Genoa, when he hit a free kick rather better than the one he hit just a moment ago.
Now, from the same spot as well. I thought to myself when he was running up, can't possibly be a goalkeeper from that distance. That's why I didn't say anything on this particular occasion.
Wouters. Falux. Aldair. Senior is well forward on the left side. Bebeto at the moment in the inside left position. Much has been made about the quality of the attack of Brazil, but no one should underestimate the quality of their defence. It's been very well organised by Carlos Alberto Pereira. Free kick conceded. Challenge on Bergkamp that time, quite rightly bringing the free kick, the early one in my opinion. He left his foot in, hoping the referee would give him the free kick as he turned himself. Now after Branco comes Koeman. Shootout in Dallas between these two. But it was better struck. And it's amazing that Jorginho, the man who headed it away, got up immediately. Bebeto. Wouters made absolutely no attempt to play the ball. He played straight through, and Bebeto caught him in the back. Will not have hurt him, in spite of the reaction of the Brazilian, but he just charged him in the back.
Well, Bebeto, knowing that Wouters is marking him so tightly, would be too disappointed to see Mark get an early yellow card, and I think that was what all the antics was about. Wouters following him all over the place, Winters following Zinho, the number nine, and of course that leaves Koeman as a spare man. They certainly don't want him picking up in defence.
Way through to Ed De Hooy. It certainly had its share of rain. The Brazilians yesterday, who trained in considerable heat here, very happy with the pitch. It's only 72 yards wide, but that didn't seem to bother them. Rob Vichka. Frank de Boer, who lost his place, complaining that he felt the effects of the heat. Show his best form. One against one for the first time. Felix equal to the challenge. Well taken. Winter. Too long. Rado van Bossen. He was down the middle. Bergkamp was out to the left.
Interesting just to see that nasty ricochet in midfield, that Felix reacted very, very well. Had good acceleration and definitely had the pace of Romario.
Well, the man from Sporting Lisbon. He gets his place not only for his ability, but for his attitude. He's very, very laid back, very relaxed about things. Sometimes the Dutch get a bit uptight and they feel that he's a good influence in the dressing room. Look like his wedding to August. Should have been at the end of this championship. Flag up for offside. Linesman not looking the sort of fella you'd argue with. Jonk. Van Bossen goes. pass is too wide. Well, I think Branko made sure that would happen. The referee wants to talk to Van Vossen. Disappointing start here from a couple of Brazilians, clearly trying to get Dutch players booked. Well played the referee in not falling for it.
I mean, it was only a token challenge by Van Vossen. Certainly the ball through from Jonk. I mean, if it had been a good one, he could have been clear, pushed him wide, and as you can see, Branko just turning away, just casually put a leg out, and Branko does a two or three rolls, and the referee started very well, I think.
Koeman, not the best of passes to Rijkaard. Koeman recovered well to take the ball off Ziga. Silva doing his main job. Just the cover across the back. When he gets forward, he does so to purpose. Dived in by Falux. Took a small divot, nobody else.
You could see there how deep Wouters is, and that's the illustration of how he is going to end up in defensive positions because he's doing that marking job on the Beta.
Free up for the Dutch. Rogicka. Zinho, who took the glide. Jonk. Branko quick to see that. Dunga. Caught by Koeman. Nothing serious. Koeman was too impressed by what he saw as another bit of acting. He nodded it down. Yeah, Koeman looked as though he tried to pull out. Certainly nothing vicious in it. And there he is. Romario, good chest trap, very low. Loses out to Phillips. Rijkaard. Vossen, Jorginho with him. How about there? Mara Silva. Bebeto. Here's Jan Wouters. A test by Jan Wouters, 34 on the day of the final. Dantas would like to end his international career by playing in it. Branko, blocked by Winter. And it came off the arm and the referee says free kick. And off the forearm, Winter. Angle not good for Branko, so he's gone to the middle and left it for the left foot of Zinho. They've arrived from the back. Marcio Santos ahead of Aldair. Too long for everybody. Quite what Vichka meant to do. Koeman. Not a soul there in a Dutch shirt.
Well, the opening 11-12 minutes of skirmishing, nobody deciding to risk too many men forward and support from midfield, and the strikers having to chase some of the balls that's not giving them that much opportunity to create any scoring chances, and of course both goalkeepers quite leisurely in this opening spell.
First wave goes around the cotton ball, orange and yellow. Dutch having come down from Orange County in Florida. played there against the Irish in the Citrus Bowl, which used to be called the Tangerine Bowl. And it certainly proved to be the Tangerine Bowl on the day. Lovely atmosphere again. So much at stake, but the crowd have come to enjoy the match. Tension there is at the moment is on the pitch. Nathan Shaw will slowly disappear. And no suggestion that it will ever come into the crowd. Up by Branco. Overmars hasn't had a chance to have a run at him yet. Maddocks does well, so does Koeman. Nice weight, nice head tennis. Vichka back again to Valters. Reichardt. Bergkamp down the middle. Jonk has got forward to make it a three up front, the third being Van Bossen. Jonk now drops square of the ball carrier. Here he is, number eight. Valters. Brazilians pushing up and getting back to cover. And Bossen gets the better of Jorginho. Reichardt is in the middle. Mauro Silva organises Brazil. Winter did well then on Zinho. Overmars at Branco, extra man across with Dunga. Overmars looking at the space behind Branco. The door was closed very early by the other defender.
First chance Overmars has had to run at Branco, and if he's going to have any joy, he's got to go outside Branco. Training yesterday, he didn't look too quick or too lively, and that is an area that I think if they can isolate the two of them, Holland could have a bit of joy.
What a good ball to Bebeto. Port Valters looking over his head. Early ball in. Romario, good block by Falux. But in fact, Romario's foot touched it last. Sudden indication, the sweeping crossfield ball that was an absolute beauty over Valters. The ball was in early, and Falux there with Romario. Goal kick.
First time Jorginho's got up to support the attack. I thought the defender did superbly well there, Felix. No chance of an opening for Romario. And Van Bossen there just being told by a couple of the Dutch midfielders, if Jorginho does come, make sure you stay with him, because he did get clear for the early cross.
Reichardt. 14 by Jonk. Nobody chasing it for Holland. Three up for Brazil. Zinho on the left, dropping shorter. Winter goes with him. Romario down the middle. Falux is with him. Bebeto out to the left. Valters is about 2 yards away. Marcio Santos again. Bebeto calls for the wide ball to the right. Dunga. And they hear. Beto stays back and Jorginho has gone forward. Mazinho. Feyenoord for 4 years. His national debut was in December 92. Everybody up. Furthest up is just ahead of those two. Perkin. Overmars. Winter. Big short for Reichardt. one-on-one. Vichka, well, there's a bit of space on the right. Mazinho, Bebeto, Romario in the middle, Zinho as well. Feeling of anticipation every time there's a break on the right and Romario runs in or around the penalty area. Feel it all around the stadium. Now Bergkamp. Rijkaard.
Bergkamp trying to hold up play there, but he was isolated. Rijkaard tried to knock it forward to Van Rossen, but just a little bit of pressure from Brazil. They had one or two openings down that right-hand side when Bebeto took Wouters wide. But at the moment, I think you have to say both coaches have done a very good job on pinpointing the dangers of the opposition.
Well, we've been playing for 20 minutes and watching the match with us, the England coach, Terry Venables.
Yes, at the moment, it's quite clear to see that the Dutch have set out their tactics purely to stifle the Brazil game. And they've done it very, very well so far. It's not the entertainment that we'd like to see, but nevertheless, it's very, very effective. And as we can see, it's Brazil that's doing all the attacking, and the Dutch are playing a waiting game. The front three attackers are not getting the game at the moment, but I believe as the game goes on, we will see much more of them.
Here's Van Vossen. Santos, Mario, Marx, had a good job so far against Romario. The concentration has to be start to finish. Just needs one chance. He's on song. Santos, lovely turnaround, Bergkamp. Here, Baltus. Rob Pichka. Boston having the left touch line, and it's Wouters who makes the forward run. And Dyer, dainty at the back. Suddenly we're playing one touch. And Taparelli included. Dunga. Taken well by Mauro Silva. Romario. This deep to find the ball. Alexis followed his run. Back again to Romario. Early shot. Bounce in front of Ed De Hoy. He actually collected the ball. His weight was on his heels.
First time he's actually come deep. He was going for the far corner to the goalkeeper's left there, but didn't catch it right.
Challenged by Jorginho, who's one of two Brazilians who has a yellow card in the second phase of the competition. Another round of the last 16 against the United States. Another one is Mazinho. The Dutch side has one yellow card against Ronald Koeman. Here's Overmars, past Branco for the first time. Takes on Marcio Santos. Dunga again comes back to help. Rijkaard's early cross. Out by Jorginho. Having had one go, wants the ball again. Jonk. Neatly done. Bollocks. Sun beginning to break through.
kick against the Dutchman. There's Peter van Vossen. Branken. Mario forward and Bebeto is left side. Is his right side for the Dutch. Good challenge by Winter. Referee well placed. Vossen really has hugged that left touchline. Against the Irish, he tended to come in and play a little closer to Bergkamp. He's done that very often in this one.
I think that's probably to make sure he occupies Jorginho and doesn't allow him to creep forward and cut out that danger.
Alex. So far, it's very interesting, but as a contest, really waiting to happen.
Well, nobody is taking the chance as we thought they might, and the Brazil, they are strong defensively, and that is one of their key areas that perhaps the other Brazilian side since 1970 haven't had. And at the moment, a patient game from the Dutch as well.
Koeman. Winter. Rijkaard is the furthest forward. Van Vossen in behind Jorginho. Blocked by Aldair. And we've got another bit of rolling. The referee entitled to say if you want treatment, go off for it. With luck, but come on, that's ridiculous.
And the problem with Van Vossen, he's got to get it back on his right foot. He hasn't got a natural left foot, and then not too keen on chancing across from that situation. He had a yard or two of space, that's when he should have whipped it in, but he tried to get it on his favoured foot, and that's in fact why he got caught with the tackle.
Big shot we had there of Brian Roy. Jonk to take the resulting free kick, and Bergkamp got underneath it and couldn't control it. First chance for the Dutch.
Definitely got a bit of space as well, got between, I think it was Marcio Santos and Dunga. You see as it comes over, it gets between the two of them, just can't get over the ball and head it down into the net.
Worried about Peter van Vossen. That seems to be okay. Branco. Zinho. Mauro Silva. Branco, nobody there. Wouters, Jonk. By Mazinho, then by Mauro Silva. Vichka. Need the challenge by Aldair. Jorginho won it. Marcio Santos covers. Couldn't stand on any ceremony that time. Applied the old principle, when in doubt, get it out. Which needs a goal to open it out. Corner. Feel that it was dangerous play, but Aldair put his head down to the ball. Referee has given the corner. First of the match. And We're in the 28th minute. Mark Overmars to take. Rijkaard comes away from the near post. Bergkamp is further back. Balak looked as though he was pushed. But the referee says nothing. Gives nothing. Romario looked as though he was pushed, but the referee allowed the advantage. This is Zinho. And now Mazinho. Dunga. Mazinho again. Mario Bebeto waiting in the middle. Well struck cross that was curling away, but not enough. But even so, a good attempt by Mazinho to pull the ball back.
He's quite a versatile midfielder, Mazinho. He's played on all different sections of the midfield in the various games since getting his chance in the side. More naturally right-footed and working the right flank in this particular game. But at the moment, the Dutch reminded me a little bit of the Swedish side that we saw draw with Brazil in the Silver Dome. Making sure they're always goal side of the Brazilians and never allowing themselves to be caught short.
Appeared there was a push on Felix, the referee called it evens. Mauro Silva, Branco's made a good run. Has to peel away. Bossen came back with him. Bossen now on the right side, Overmars on the left. Mauro Silva, Dunga. Mazinho, bit of space for Mauro Silva. Hit it well! They worked it well to find a bit of space on the right. And he certainly struck the ball very, very cleanly. Romario made the opening. You can see Falux going off with Romario. That set up the chance, the opening.
Wasn't that far away. I think even Mauro Silva was surprised how much time Rooney had. And he took the extra little knock on. Just got a little bit caught underneath him and didn't quite get the control, but it wasn't far away. The best sort of clearest shooting chance we've had, but neither goalkeeper's had to make what I would call a real save.
Bebeto, away by Koeman, not well, straight back to the player who tried to play it through. Signs that the Brazilians are raising the tempo. This is Branco. Settled down and getting involved a little bit more. Good interception there by Falux. Brilliantly won by Mauro Silva. Not brilliantly struck by Dunga.
He hasn't quite got his shooting boots on in this tournament, Dunga, but the man behind him, Mauro Silva, who made the initial tackle, has had a superb tournament. Just sort of sits in front of the two central defenders, and strong, and then when he carries the ball forward, a very dominating presence on the field.
Don't need the Ray-Bans on the clock today. Bergkamp, shirt stood the test, again the referee played advantage. Dutch responding to a better spell from Brazil. Binta. Wim Jonk. Bitschke, Bossen on that touchline again. Bergkamp down the middle. That's a nothing ball. And a corner. The linesman says that it touched Branco. Bergkamp at the moment is in the six-yard area. Rijkaard takes a position in front of him. Van Bossen at the back. It's struck in. Mauro Silva got his head to it. Bergkamp! Quality attempt, even if he didn't make it. There was so little room to bend it round, but he went for it.
I think he was trying to drag it away outside the penalty area, and he told a dummy to the defender, but then he tried to pick a spot in the near post. Tafarel always had it covered.
Mauro Silva. Zinho again. It's a ball in with pace, but Romario was moving just the other way, couldn't correct the run. Wouters. Rijkaard. Jong. Telegraph the pass and didn't need the challenge by Jorginho. And Boston entitled to feel aggrieved on that occasion.
One or two of the previous referees, I think, might have ventured out with one or two extra yellow cards to what the Costa Rican referee has so far. But
free kick to Brazil. We're in the 35th minute. Just signs, Terry, that things are beginning to open out a little bit.
Well, they're playing a man-to-man marking to extremes, the Dutch. And the Brazil are playing a strict 4-4-2 and not really giving them any problems. There's no interchanging of positions. They're playing this 4-4-2, which really the Dutch are just handling actually very well. I think that we're speaking about Mauro da Silva. He's been an outstanding player at the moment. He's a big influence. And I think it's fair to say that if one side's going to take the lead, they have to be a little bit more adventurous. But again, both sides, I think, are concerned that they'll concede space to the opposition. And while it's 0-0, I think we'll see it carrying on in the same fashion.
There's Mauro Silva. Roberto doesn't make a run for him. He just stayed out on the right, comes through to Romario, a little fortunately. And he used his arm to control the ball. Jonk. Wouters. Vossen did it well. Jorginho up alongside. We'll see, he got no further. Koeman. Rijkaard. Jonk. Up for Brazil, watched by three. Bebeto on the right side. Mazinho. Dunga. Marcio Santos. Not the sort of ball that Romario will appreciate. And he turns to him. The indication seems to be play it and beat. This is how he certainly prefers it.
They definitely dropped off wanting it to feed once it went behind him. I mean, they know thanks very much. And at the moment, Felix doing an excellent job on Romario. But as you say, it's one of those you've got to keep the concentration for the whole of the 90 minutes. He only needs just that one lapse and you've conceded a goal.
Speed of turn then by Marcio Santos. Mario coming deep for Marcio Santos. For a moment then was the furthest forward. Romario again. I'd see him do a bit more of that. Suddenly somebody else is in his stead. The Dutch cover is not there. That's what they'd be hoping. Mazinho. Romario. Bebeto, Romario's down on the deck, so is Bebeto, and the second one brings the free kick. Listen to the reaction from the Brazilian supporters. It's matched by a suck in of breath from those wearing orange. Bullocks made the challenge. The first one, Rijkaard, the second one, the second called the foul. All sorts of possibilities. They're leaving it at the moment to Bebeto and Franco. Jorginho has gone to the right. There are four at the end of the Dutch wall wearing blue. So two of them have stayed, now two have come out. Franco wants to get it round the wall, so those two will duck. Franco takes, tries to get it over the top of the wall. Big men good enough, and the ball had gone out. It's a corner.
There's seven in the wall there, so they were very conscious. I can't see how on earth Buhui would have seen the ball at all, but Franco trying to just curl it over. I thought he'd go for Pau there. And he comfortably dealt with it in the end.
He's curling a bit, and Bahia trying to get there. Rijkaard did. This is Bebeto. By Binta. Zinho. Franco. Away from Binta. Out by Baltis. Dunga. Free kick is given. And the referee shows the yellow card to Aaron Winter. And other things he might have called. A man from Costa Rica finally brings out the yellow card as we approach the end of the 40th minute.
I mean, there's no need to challenge through the back like that because Franco wasn't going to do much with the ball anyway there, and that's an unnecessary yellow card. Vinto has done a good marking job on Zinho, the number nine. Franco just getting magic sponge there. Isn't as mobile as Leandro, or of course Cafu, who came on and played against USA, who some people thought might have played in this particular game. Looks as if he's going to have to get the magic sponge working a bit more off the pitch.
The fact that Cafu is not playing is a suggestion of the conservative approach, which has been matched by the Dutch coach as well. In fact, more so. Bebeto takes it. Well out by Rijkaard. What a good header.
Well, Dyer coming in on the far post, and absolutely vital Rijkaard got to that cross.
Mario just outside the six-yard area. Jorginho is on the near post. Marcia Santos and Adair both up. Marcia Santos! And really not very far away. Diving header. Look at the angle of the body when he actually makes contact with the ball. Did really well and was unlucky. I think if it had been coming back in, Balthus would have met it.
Whipping in with the left foot there. Good flicked header, and Balthus jumping as high as he can. I'm not sure whether he could have kept it out, but I'm sure relieved that it went beyond the far post.
Romario. First time he's run at people. Good cover again by Phillips. Those were seemingly elastic legs. Romario again. Phillips stays away off him. Dunga. Too strong.
The other good thing about Phillips, very easy, he can tackle with either foot. I mean, that last one with his left foot, and I've seen him make a couple of similar ones with his right, so he's not restricted if the forward goes either side of him.
Plenty of variation in Dutch style on the terraces. As yet, not enough variation from Dick Advocaat's team. push. Referee says no. De Huy. Mr. Santos. Vinter. Cover Branco on a slip and then a handball. Well, why didn't Romario go on? Could surely have got to the ball.
I think the referee's pulled it up for actually Romario clipping the heels of Alex there. There it is. And so the whistle was blown very quickly and he's pulled him back. Romario saying it was an accident, but it certainly was a key factor in him having a clear run to goal.
Surprising even so that he didn't carry on. Seemed to be hoping he was going to get a deliberate handball. Referee has had a really very good first half. Bautis. Bergkamp. Long way off any marker. Better of Bergkamp in the air. Kim Jong trying to get Van Bossen in behind Jorginho. Those two have really cancelled each other out. Van Bossen has not had too much change in attack, but his presence has prevented Jorginho also attacking, and that's been the case in so many areas of the field. And as a result, we're not yet seeing the match that we'd hoped for. Who's most prepared to gamble? Couldn't make that. Free kick, unnecessary challenge by Branco. De Jong comes to take control. Bergkamp, Rijkaard, and Van Bossen. Bergkamp and Rijkaard far post. Van Bossen on the near side. Here he is. Jong, it was too short, the return ball. Good reaction by Vinter. Good pace, quick and short strides. Jonk. Zinho. Dutch supporters still hopeful here. The Brazilians haven't got it away yet. A little stoppage time, but not much for the referee to allow. Up come Brazil. Again, the referee well placed. And they hear, nice little drop pass, this is Zinho, extra touch, now it's on his wrong foot, Romario going at the heart of the defence, and the poke shot in the end, after lovely stuff from Romario, and the man who touched it last was Adair.
Well, that was the best flowing move of the first half. Romario does brilliantly here, and Adair, I think being a central defender, wasn't quite reading the little toe poke to the side and was on his heels and then was at full stretch when he tried to. In fact, as you see Zinho come in, he feeds it into Romario, and then it was Aldair then who in fact just wasted what was probably the best opening Brazil have created.
Well won by Jorginho. Foul by Dunga.
But a very even contest, isn't it, the first half. And Brazil, I mean, they've been criticised by one or two of their own media, Pelé included, for perhaps being a little bit too defensive in midfield. Mauro Silva's been the outstanding player on the field, the number five. But I must say, Dunga alongside Mazzinho, those three are more defensive players. And it means Zinho is the only more attacking one. And I wonder if it stays sort of this cautious approach for a quarter of an hour into the second half, whether somebody like Raí might come on.
Muscled a bit by Branco. Free kick was inevitable.
To balance up that argument, of course, you can hardly say the Dutch have been that adventurous themselves.
As you can argue, the nearer you get to success, the tighter the matches become. Jonk to take the free kick. Dutch have five in the box. At the back is Rijkaard. Vanhoek's underneath it, out by Jorginho. Bergkamp shot blocked. Koeman. The danger passes, but for the neutral, there has not been enough danger in the first 45 minutes of this contest. Both sides concerned not to give anything away, but maybe the second half will show a different story. The question is, who will be the first to gamble, and will it be a successful one? Half-time score in the Cotton Bowl in Dallas. Holland, the Netherlands 0, Brazil 0.
Well, we billed it as a potential classic, and it's still a potential classic.
It can only get better, that's for sure. The Dutch have been disappointing because they've got men behind the ball, they've defended deep, they've left the front men isolated, they haven't supported at all. I think it's back to the old story, the fear factor. They're scared of going a goal down, having to come up and hitting the break, or Brazil hitting them in the break and get a thrashing. Brazil, for their part, haven't thrown that many men forward either, but they've been enterprising the last 10, 15 minutes, and if there's one side looked like they were going to score, it was Brazil.
It's bound to be fear factor, though, isn't it, Jim? There's so much at stake when you get to this stage.
Yes, there is. One goal dispenses with that in a way, because then the other side has to come out and play and try and equalise. We hadn't had the goal. We have had a very interesting referee. We've enjoyed, I think, refereeing the game, whose approach to it is totally different.
Hasn't got a card on him.
Well, I wonder whether he left him in the dressing room, but he did actually show one at one point there for a rather violent lunge in the air.
But we'll have a look at that in a moment. But let's look at some of the chances. And I mean, the best one for Holland was our man Bergkamp.
Yeah, it came from a set play, free kick. Great ball and difficult to defend against. Bergkamp gets between two defenders, and I think he's a bit unlucky for him. It just comes at a bad angle, and he puts over the top. Maybe he should have done better.
Just looking how many Brazilians were there, there are seven really between the goal and the original ball, but he still manages to get up. I mean, that's very poor defending, Alan. You would hate to be responsible
for
that.
Yeah, he got between
you?
The two of them. Mm. Maybe just a little nudge in him there as he was going ahead.
Terry Venables mentioned Mara da Silva for Brazil. He thought he was outstanding. You think so too? He's involved in this.
I thought he was been terrific in the first half. Yeah. It's actually a great passing move, and it's give, go, get it back. It's into feet. And he does particularly well because he brings it across here. And again, it's all about movement. It's all about pass and move. And eventually when it comes to him, he's in a little bit of space. It's a good first touch, takes it on. And this is a scintillating shot from 20, 25 yards that would have given the goalkeeper no chance.
The part I find interesting in this, oh, there's just the final shot, but there were four Dutch players that they beat by the first into passing, and there were still five left to go through at the moment that he had that shot.
But that was the one occasion that they had men forward, and when you're passing and moving and you're getting rid of Dutch defenders, then the space, you create the space, you open up, and it did open up there, and he had a bit of time and space on the edge of the box, and that's what's really been missing in the game.
Plays in Spain, doesn't he, La Coruña. Now, Marcio Santos had a chance. Let's have a look at this one.
Great ball, and again.
Yeah.
Difficult to defend against, whipped in, good header, but unlucky. Just gone past the post. The
defender was in the right place, mind you.
Yeah, more defenders than attackers, but as Alan says, he did extremely well to get his head in there against tight marking, and not far. You know, the difference between going in and out, you're fractional.
Now here, right at the end of that half, was perhaps the nicest move of all as far as Brazil were concerned.
Good football. Mm. Good football on the edge of the box.
Yeah, we got terribly excited at this point because it really was vintage Brazil. Crisp passing, players to spare, chances opening up. That little back
heel
there,
here.
Leaving it, knowing Romario in the end is the one who carves out the opening. There it is, beautiful dummy, on his left foot, you see, totally two-footed, making the chance, little wriggle through, touch to the right, and that's a goal, isn't it? Except for a great interception there by a defender who can't quite see who that was, but we might pick him out this time because he saved them from getting a goal. That tackle.
Good challenge, good late challenge, because he's clear through. But that stage,
the chance came to Aldair, who's the central defender.
Central defenders have a nosebleed in that position, don't they?
that's what we
that's
were
me included.
To see. Yeah, that's what we've been sitting here and sitting at home waiting to see Brazil
that
like
sort
that
sort of stuff.
Yeah, really, really.
You were talking about referees just now. We had a referee the other night who couldn't stop sending people off and offering cars and all the rest of it. Tonight we've got one who's rather more lenient.
Absolutely extraordinary. Yeah, quite honestly.
But he's a better referee. I mean, I think he's controlling the game rather well, don't you?
Yeah, but I do. I mean, I like his fashion of refereeing. I mean, I'm sure we all do, but it's a different standard of refereeing. It's against giving fluttering yellow cards all over the place.
Here's an incident when he might have... This was Jorginho on Van Vossen.
Yeah. Now, you see, throughout the competition, never mind the diving, I mean, if he wanted to go up in the air, he may not have gone up quite as high as he did there.
But it was a tackle from behind, wasn't it?
It was a tackle from behind, the sort that FIFA have said, we are going to stamp out. And they
should have done it.
It was a bookable offence.
It was a bookable offence.
It was a bookable offence, which wasn't given.
I've got to move on. Go on now then. The earlier quarter-final in Boston, Italy against Spain. This is how it turned out. Commentary from Tony Gubber.
Massaro switches the play. Dino Baggio and Donadoni, faced by Ferrer. Dino Baggio might think about a shot. Oh, it's a great effort! Wonderful goal, Dino Baggio! 25 minutes gone, Italy open the scoring. The pace of the match just beginning to pick up a little bit. Under the feet, Caminiero! Equaliser! Luis Enrique, whose strength won the ball. And the deflection off the boot of Benarivo, beating Pagliuca. Spain patient and methodical in the build-up. And now over the top of Salinas. Flag stayed down, it would have counted. Here's Caminiero. Play waved on again. Salinas should have scored. And Spain might have lost their chance to get into the semi-finals. Here's Berti. Signori. To Roberto Baggio, he'll get there. Baggio, still Baggio, he's gone wide. Baggio produces the magic. Italy lead 2-1. And there are less than 3 minutes to play. Signori knew exactly where he was. Baggio just kept himself onside. And in a similar position to the one from which Salinas failed to score at the other end. Roberto Baggio beat the defender at the post.
So it's Italy to play Germany or Bulgaria in the semi-final. Baggio does it again. Now, there was an incident in that game which might have changed the course of it, Alan.
Incredible, it was. Yeah. It was right at the very end, and it was Tassotti and Luis Enrique.
Luis Enrique, yeah.
And we've got them highlighted here. Now, Tassotti is maybe 8 yards goal side of Luis Enrique, but Luis Enrique tries to get past him to get into the space at the back post. He makes a burst for the space. Tassotti doesn't let him pass, and you can clearly see he elbows him there. And it was crazy, because if you look at the clock, 48 minutes and 6 seconds. We see it from this angle. Look at the top of the picture. The elbow comes up and whacks in the
now
nose.
Now we're talking sending off.
Penalty.
We're talking penalty. And we're talking broken nose, by the way. The Spanish player got a broken nose at the end of that. That's been confirmed. Jim?
Yes, he didn't pick that up through falling on the grass. And so the extraordinary thing is, when you talk about justice, that Tassotti will be playing in the semi-final. And Kremenlyev, who was totally innocent of any offence...
The Bulgarian,
although he was sent off in the game, FIFA haven't put that right by making him available for their match against the West Germans.
Bit of injustice,
so, I mean,
kicking around.
That's not right, is it?
It
can't be right whichever way you look at it.
Thank you. Now, how would you like to actually go to the World Cup final on Sunday week in Pasadena, California? Sounds marvellous. 2 tickets and all travel expenses available for the winner of our competition. You have to pick the top 3 goals in the right order to agree with the choice of Jimmy and Alan from these 10. And here they come.
Ronaldo. Oh, it's in! Equalised. It's Eric Winalda
States.
Well, that's a good run. Beautiful goal. Batistuta gets his second. Here is a striker supreme. Klinsmann does well. Hassler has room. Riedler, far post. Klinsmann thinks about coming across. Here he is. Turns. A good run. He's done it again. Romario.
This is Owairan. A good run. Good strong run. Still in possession, Owairan. Still there. They've scored again.
Amokachi trying to go alone. Still Amokachi, brilliant run. Oh, what a fantastic goal! Back from Klinsmann. Good play by Rudy Voller. Klinsmann takes over and scores. Here comes Hadji. Little ball in. Oh, and a chance and a goal! To make Sescu again! Oh, and Forbes. Waldo was the player that got caught, and he's out of the game now, and Romania have got two against one. Selimes coming to the left. This is Dumitrescu. There's a player up on the right. And is this 3-1? It is! It's that inevitable man, Gheorghe Hadji. And Yordanov for Bulgaria has come in today, number 13. And he's got a through ball on there. And a chance for Bulgaria. And a fine goal. Stoichkov.
Tough task from those goals, but you have to pick your top three to agree with the choice of the lads here. Phone into that number, and if you're the first one out of the hat, or the computer as we call it these days, you might be off to the World Cup live. The only disadvantage to winning that competition is that you'll miss a fantastic double bill we have for World Cup final night on Sunday week. At 6:15 that evening, we'll bring you a fabulous concert from Los Angeles. It's called Encore, the Three Tenors. Carrera, Domingo, Pavarotti, you remember him, and you'll remember their inspiring concert in Rome around World Cup time 4 years ago. That precedes the final itself on that night, which of course comes live on BBC. Incidentally, tomorrow early evening, you can see World Champions Germany against Bulgaria here on BBC One. And on Wednesday, we'll have the primetime semi-final at 9 o'clock that evening. Now, as you know, Terry Venables is at the match, so let's have a view from Terry now. What have you spotted in this match that might win it for either side, Terry?
Well, one of the things is I think I can't get used to Brazil playing in blue. I think that's one of the reasons that it's not going too well. I do feel that they're attacking on the right side particularly well. That's one of the advantages they have at the moment. But I must say on the left side there's nothing at all. And although Branco is doing a particularly good job against Overmars, I think that they do miss Leonardo with the surging runs that we've seen in the previous games.
But do you think Brazil will out here? Do you think they'll come through in the end? That's what we feel at this end.
The game is riddled with fear, and I think the guilty party really is Holland. They really have played man-to-man marking wherever they've gone. Mauro Silva had a good chance, as you said earlier, outside the box. But when his forwards ran away, the defenders ran away with him. And that's one of the things with man-to-man marking. You can't get any pressure on the ball. And really, that could have put him one ahead.
Thanks, Terry. Good to see you in your changed colour of pink tonight, by the way.
And it's amazing the distances I'll go to get away from Jimmy's singing.
We'll stay with you now. Thanks, Terry. We'll stay with you there and move out to Trevor and Barry.
Well, Terry's moved in to our hotel, of course, here in Dallas. And talking of singing, the Brazilians have taken over the hotel. And this morning, I heard two of them practicing the Star Spangled Banner. For what reason, I wasn't prepared to ask them. At the moment, the flags of the two countries, neither is being flown at full mast. Fear, lads have all talked about, and it's been interesting listening to Terry and occasionally looking at his face as we get close-ups of the two coaches here. And in 4 years' time, he'll be having to make the sort of decisions as to when to gamble, actually to come a bit earlier than that, of course, in the European Championships. And we can remind him that he talked about others with fear. But he's always been a gambler, hasn't he? He's smiling. Two teams, as you can see, on their way back. It's the very efficient referee from Costa Rica. It's his third game. He did Nigeria against Bulgaria. He showed one yellow card to each side, and then he did Bolivia, losing 3-1 to Spain. He only showed two yellow cards, and the second of those came in the very last minute. And he gave Spain one of the 13 penalties of this World Cup, all of which have been successfully put away. Claudio Taffarel, like his opposite number, really has had only the role of a spectator and just the occasional man to tidy up. Substitutes taking their position, but some of them are cut across the corner of the pitch, which is why the referee can't get the second half underway. So who will change things first? Bossen. Lim Jonk, Bichka, the first three Dutchmen involved. Mazinho for Brazil. Free kick is given to Holland. They've used 17 of their 22 players. Holland, the Brazilians, one fewer. Jonk to take, Falux has got forward. He was looking for the nod down, but it was too strong for Rijkaard to make that nod down.
No tactical changes. The markers picking up as before. Wouters staying with Bebeto. Zinho being marked by Winter over the other side. And Falux with Romario, with Koeman free. But up to now, of course, not venturing forward. Quite happy just to play deep and spray it from that situation.
Zinho. So many of the matches in the round of 16 were given early lift-off by an early goal. So far, that's not been the case in the two quarter-finals. Challenge was late. Falux. Mario looks up at the referee. Fourth cap this match for Romario Faria from Barcelona these days. 28 goals to his credit. Very good striking rate. Artists. Rijkaard. Right, Vichka. Pity, because there would have been some space for Vignon if that pass had been more accurate. Ball for Romario from Bebeto. Romario with all of it to do. And the extra turn, Falux was able to get in the challenge, but a really good ball by Bebeto.
Well, just for once, Falux got the wrong side of him, didn't he? And Romario trying to take it in his stride, wasn't quite able to, so he got pushed wide on his left foot. He doesn't like to hit him with that, and it showed there, didn't it? Tried to do a spin and get it onto his favoured foot, and the opportunity was lost. For me, that was the best chance of the match so far.
Dunga. Koeman. Overmars. This was a negative one. He had some space, never thought about going at Branca. Equally, Jonk was not prepared to go square for Bergkamp, stayed back. That was a feeling for offside. It was never anywhere near offside. This is the little fellow again, Romario. Overmars, who came back to take it off him. Vinter.
Romario a bit unlucky against Falux down the left there. Branco for once didn't overlap and took Overmars back with him. And it was Overmars then who doubled up and made the tackle on Romario, who was shocked, I think, to see him come outside.
Vichka. Jonk. Lawson was trying to find Vichka. Said Banzinho. Vichka late with the challenge. Romario to the left makes the diagonal run. Bebeto on this side. Zinho has got into space at the back post, but the cross wasn't quite good enough.
They got a bit ragged now, haven't they, the Dutch defence? The last 3 or 4 minutes got caught, dived in on a couple of tackles. Bebeto then on the right was clear, and he just hung his cross rather than clip it over the top, and it gave the opportunity for De Huy to come out and collect.
Whistles for Rob Ritschke. This was the Brazilian attack, little clip up, but it wasn't good enough, and De Huy came to collect with some comfort.
That wasn't the opportunity, that certainly wasn't the opportunity to hang it in the air. He had to put it over in place, and then the goalkeeper couldn't have come out and collect.
Rijkaard, Jonk. Taparel coming to meet it. Just wonder whether the Dutch will regret this policy that they're employing. So many teams, not only in the game of association football, only really start showing their mettle when they go behind. And there's every chance that the Dutch are going to go behind here. Mario, Jorginho, Vichka, just the best of clearances, came off Van Posse, Mazinho, that's good moving left, second time that Branco has got forward, but now there's a hole that is left, Rijkaard. Signs towards the end of the half that things were opening out, and the start of the second half they certainly are. Romario is in the middle and scores! Four goals in 5 games. Classic break. And Romario gets a standing ovation in the Cotton Bowl. Everybody wants to hug him. Only those on the field are allowed to. Referee notes the goal that gives Brazil the lead. Bebeto on the left side. He knew it would find the finish. And Romario was the finisher.
great early cross from Roberto. He got to wrong side of Wouters just for once. Romario again just ahead of Ballack. And you can't allow that with those two quality strikers. They make the most of it. And all that hard work now has been undone for the Dutch team. And they've got to now suddenly readjust and look more positive.
Goal in the 52nd minute of the match. Now the Dutch have to show their more positive side. He who dares wins. Rijkaard. Jonk. Nearly. Good interception by Aldair. And Romario down the middle, and De Hooy comes way out.
You have to admire the finish of Romario, though, don't you? It was almost as if it was a five-a-side practice game. He just stroked it into the net. And Dick Advocaat reacts very quickly. Ryan Rohr comes into the fray.
He's replacing Peter van Bossen. Rather adopted this policy on the warmer days. Van Bossen said to his coach, I'll run my socks off for 60 minutes and then you can make a change. But it hasn't been a hot day. Ryan Roy will be with Nottingham Forest next season. Gets the chance to show the other face of Holland. They are a good attacking side. In fact, if truth be told, Trevor, they're a far better side when they're attacking. But their concern has been for perceived weaknesses at the back.
Well, that's got to be abandoned now. And there's no way that they should have left Overmars with so little of the ball. I mean, I do feel he has got the beating of Branko for pace. But even when he's got it to feet, he too has been reluctant to have a go at the fullback and take him on. And perhaps Roy can do it this side against Jorginho, but they have got to adopt a far more attacking outlook now, and Koeman has got to come forward more and start to spray those passes. This is the ball for the goal. I mean, superb crossfield ball, wasn't it, that opened up the defence.
Dunga looking for the offside, and they've got it, but it was tight. Jorginho very comfortably read that, and Vichka now has to chase. Jorginho plays it into Bebeto. Romario is just behind him. Bebeto goes for the shot and clips the far post. Entitled to have a go. He scored one earlier in the competition from that sort of angle. Romario made the run to him. There was another player out to the left side, and Bebeto thought he could find a gap to the right as he was challenged, and he was very unlucky that he didn't succeed.
Wouters lost him again. Felix had to come across, try to retrieve it, click the outside of the post. But I mean, they're getting a bit ragged, aren't they? Wouters is getting his man lost. Felix is then caught between Romario and the fellow striker, Bebeto. So at the moment, Holland got to do a bit of reorganising.
Attacking football is winning. By the scruff of the neck. Romario goes away! Good stop. So quick to accelerate with those little feet, little strides, took him away from folks.
He has wonderful balance, doesn't he? He's so strong and just pushes off the mark. And at the moment, in the last 20 minutes, he's just exploded into another gear and just looks one of the top strikers, doesn't he, in the world, and proving that.
Well, he said, this will be my World Cup. Could just be right. Continue to attempt to play the ball then by the defender, Forrocks. Headed back pass. Taffarel remains the spectator. Beaten only by Kenneth Andersson, scorer for Sweden. Sweden-Romania in the same half of the draw. The winners of this one play the winners of that one. Overmars right side, Roy left side. They've got two quick wingers and they've got to bring them into the match. Vichka. Roy starts to go. Vichka tries to get it in. Hasn't been supplied with a ball yet, Van Roy. Any previous meeting between these two in the World Cup came, of course, in the finals. It was on July the 3rd, 1974 in Dortmund, when Holland won by 2-0. Scorers Neeskens and Cruyff. I'm not wondering whether Cruyff, had he been the coach here, whether he would have adopted a more progressive manner. Dunga. Mario looks to go again, and this half, Fanux has had to look to see where he is instead of being with him. Well played, Winter. The teams have only met on two other occasions, both of the matches in Holland, and each side having a 1-0 victory. The hour. Is it past the moment for Holland? Bergkamp. Roy down the middle. Still hasn't received the ball.
Made enough runs. What interests me more than anything, though, is Bergkamp, who hasn't been able to have the sort of influence the Dutch would like. And I think a second striker, if it stays much longer, you've got Vossman, you've got Ronald de Boer, who could come on, and then I think the Dutch have to gamble and play perhaps with the two wingers and two strikers down the middle.
Easily done. Mauro Silva, Jorginho, Bebeto was played a bit short. Mario. The flank didn't go up, but it looked as though there was an offside. Everybody stopped, and this is Bebeto. That's the second goal. The Dutch can't believe it. Everyone stopped on the field for a moment. It's Samba time at the Cotton Bowl. Dutch still can't believe it, and the referee is slowly making his way over to talk to the linesman.
Well, it's a classic case of the new rule, because he definitely, I think it was Romario initially, was walking back, was in an offside position, but because the new rule says he's not interfering with play, but the Dutch just assumed he was, and they stopped, and of course that is fatal. Rebato then one against one, does the simple, gets it on his little right foot, tucks it in, and I think that is the game over.
Well, one is reminded of the remark of the late Danny Blanchflower: if you're not interfering with play, what are you doing on the pitch? But it's been made clear to players that if you're coming from an offside position and not seeking to get involved, the linesman will not put up his flag. And Brazil have a two-goal lead. And Holland are ready to collect their tickets for going home. Overmars. Jonk. That's the spirit of Cruyff, Naiskins, Ruud Krol and company to be found on the modern Dutch side. Here's Dennis Bergkamp, to whom they look the most. It's gone! Brilliantly taken. Wonderful for the game, great for the Dutch. The sea of orange waves around the stadium.
Absolutely vital that Holland got a goal back as quickly as that. Brazil still, I think, thinking about that second goal celebrated, went to sleep on the throw-in, a quick throw, it bounced its way through, defender sold himself, Bergkamp stayed on his feet, just tucked it calmly in the far post.
And Ronald de Boer, the forward playing of the two twins, waiting his moment to come on. And they're bringing off Frank Rijkaard as we look again at the fine finish by Bergkamp. Chance, some observations from Terry Venables.
Yes, well, they've scored a goal there and they've not really attacked. I mean, they've never really took their defensive tactics into a counter-attack position, and it's the first time they've gone at them, they've scored a goal. And I think they may regret, if they don't get this game back, that they've never found out how their attacking tactics, which they've employed so far, would have gone on. And that must be a big disappointment to them.
Bergkamp did it so well. He took on two, balanced himself, and flicked past the advancing Tadio Taparel. So this quarter-final seemed to be all over, is again very much alive. Jorginho.
Been able to get a notable impression on this game. There, Ronald de Boer, who's come on playing more the forward man now, and Dennis Bergkamp just dropping into that deeper role, and I think it's going to be Mauro Silva who will have to keep an eye on him.
Only de Boer's first touch had been better. Roy might have been in there. Given away by Marcio Santos. Wim Jonk thought by some in the Dutch camp that a few early shots against Claudio Taparel, who hasn't really been tested in the tournament, would have been a good idea. Never gave themselves a chance of doing that. That's the first that Jonk has had from distance.
Yeah, got a bit of space there, hasn't he? Went between the defender's legs but didn't catch it right. He scored two. from outside the penalty area. Ireland and Saudi Arabia looking for a hat-trick, but not with them struck like that.
Good advantage play by the referee again, Mazinho. He says to Mazinho, get up. Bergkamp. There's a certain disarray among the Brazilians. They were celebrating and thinking about going to Los Angeles. Indeed, Carlos Alberto Pereira said, I'm only thinking of victory. This is before the match. We've already started to make plans for going to Los Angeles. One or two of his players joined him in that after the second goal. Can't entirely blame them. They haven't got the muse back yet.
I think that was one of them. I said probably that's the game over with, and then Holland went promptly up and got the goal back. But they've just got to reorganise and settle back again, Brazil. I think they got carried away with that second goal. Thought there's an opportunity perhaps to show a few of our thrills. And Bergkamp, I think, definitely is going to be happier in that deeper role. He had a good attack and run at the Brazilian defence. And now that they've got four options up there, there is the opportunity for Holland to get the second goal.
Jonk. Vichka. Overmars on the right side. Bouters. Into Koeman. Let's move into the opposition half. This is Winter. Just didn't run. Here's Roy. Oh, he's unlucky. Just cannot get into the match. He's made runs all over the place. Hasn't yet been able to collect the ball.
Early ball from Koeman there. One of the few occasions when he has ventured forward, threaded it through to Winter. Winter, who I think, probably been one of the pick of the Holland players.
The Dutch do now seem to be playing three at the back, with Wouters on the right, Ferencz in the middle, and Koeman. There are certainly moments when they go forward. Those are the three that are left back. And Koeman, as we saw on the last attack, got forward as well. They've got to take that sort of chance.
Just over 20 minutes, they're looking patient, they're not trying to hurry the ball forward. Mauro Silva just knocking it out of play, not too impressed that he thought the referee was going to allow play to continue.
Bebeto is the injured player. Michael Mario plays his football in Spain for La Coruña. Mario plays for Barcelona. Covered from colliding here with Jan Wouters. Took him out for all the world like an ice hockey defenseman, a hip check. He's the key man for Holland, there's no doubt about that. Miles have remained on the faces. Maybe slight concern. Bergkamp asleep. Dunga. Overmars coming back inside. De Boer, Overmars, blocked by Branco. Two weight in the middle, Roy and Bergkamp. This is Winter. Good strike, good stop. Bergkamp. Somebody was keen to try and get back outside Jorginho. Has certainly shifted. Beto now back on the pitch. Zinho, Mazinho, seen by Jonk.
Been a much better second half. Winter hitting the ball well, going to creep inside that post, isn't it? Taffarel at full stretch. seemed to see it that early and went for it late.
Zidane and Dutch sitting side by side. Four back to watch them. Jonk, Bergkamp, Winter. Wouters were getting forward then, leaving just two at the back. Jonk just drops back to a position on the right side, a bit deeper. Good ball into Wim Jonk. Beautifully outside. Dunga, who pulls him back and will surely be booked.
Well, there, no question, is there? Please come back. And the referee right on the spot, had to be a yellow card. Jonk looking for another shooting opportunity on his right foot, but not sure he'll take it from here. Just a Koeman stepping up.
Vanderwaal checking on the left side before he moves across to the right. Koeman doesn't think that's 10 yards. Referee agrees by half a yard. Of course, they've moved back after he pointed. Koeman strikes. Ball does the job. Plenty forward for the Dutch. Koeman got the stats showing, but he gets away with it, and the corner is given. Mario Silva with words to say. Still haven't recovered, Brazil, and Holland need to take advantage of that fact. Nicked him with the side of the foot, out by Dunga. This is Wim Jonk. It just didn't run for him, came off his thigh. Good advantage play once again. Zinho, offside just. He couldn't get into his own half, Romario. Very, very tight. And the flag goes up.
I think that's a bad decision. I've got to see that on the replay. But when he played the ball, he was definitely, for me, onside.
Koeman. Wim Jonk. Dennis Bergkamp. Well out, gets for the return, goes for the right foot, it hit Marcio Santos, and it's a corner. The Dutch thought it hit the hand of Marcio Santos. And Bergkamp, breathing down somebody's neck. Almost gave him a haircut. Boos from the Dutch supporters who feel they've had the rough edge of two decisions. Taffarel, nowhere near it, Winter was! It's 2-2! What a turnaround! And all credit to the Dutch. The only question is, why didn't they start like this?
Taffarel there, 6-yard header for me. Yeah, the cross comes over. Winter deserved the goal. If you see as he's curling in with the right foot, where he eventually heads it, gets in front of his marker. Taffarel in no man's land, groping at thin air. Goalkeeping error, nowhere near the ball.
Goalkeeper, really, Taffarel was standing still. He wasn't coming to attack the ball. He was waiting to see what would happen.
Winters had an excellent second half, though. So versatile, right back then, he's pushed further into midfield, got away from his marker, and a comfortable header in the end.
He's finally been released. Branco for the free kick. Guided over.
supremely well struck.
It's a matter of the distance. Curled just a little bit, was very well watched. Marcio Santos comes forward. Jorginho. Mazinho. Before this match, Brazil had conceded just the one goal. Scored seven. Got it to 9-1. And they've conceded two to make this one all square. Bichka. Koeman. Offside. Not so much, I think, against Bichka as against Brown Roy down the middle.
The second half, I think, has developed into the game we thought it would be. First half, that cautious one. Brazil taking the lead, getting the second. I think celebrating too early. And whilst they were, Holland got their vital, so vital goal back to get to 2-1. That gave them the momentum. And at the moment, you have to say, they had the initiative.
Here's Wim Jonk. Now has the freedom to pull a few strings. Ronald de Boer. Bayer. Bouters. Back three. The Dutch now playing the way that they like to play. A balance with three at the back. It takes chances, but it produces opportunities.
It gives Bergkamp the space now to drop deeper and just a little bit heavy with the ball to Roy. And with the substitutes proving dividends for Holland, probably a time for Brazil to make one of their own, bringing Ray back into the fray themselves.
This is Franco, fed by Romario. Zinho has come square. Branco withstanding the challenges. Gets the free kick, which he was in part looking for. And Koeman reacted afterwards, and the referee going to sort it out.
You're quite right, he was looking for it. Almost threw himself at the two Dutch defenders. It's a sort of range that he likes to take a free kick. He's holding Overmars off there. That says cheerio to you. And then as he comes in field, he almost just dives forward, look, as soon as he makes contact with Jonk. Gets the free kick, though.
Koeman went to play the ball and made contact with the body with boot. Substitution to be made. Mazinho is the player withdrawn. And the man who came here as the Brazilian captain, Ray Oliveira, Paris Saint-Germain, gets back into the action. Franco would take the free kick that he won. Par again. Oh! Wonderful strike! Oh, the manner in which he won the free kick was hugely questionable. The way in which he took the free kick, one can only admire. Absolute blockbuster.
It was a great strike, but he's hit it to the side of the wall. The wall looking round and saying, well, where is the goalkeeper? It's gone between those two, but it's the side the goalkeeper to who he is standing, and the players on the outfield would always say that should be the goalkeeper to save that. That's not taken away how well he had struck the shot, though.
Just inside the post, away from the fingers of Ed De Huy. Brazil back in front. We're in the 82nd minute. Koeman. Bouters. De Huy can now only watch and hope that his countrymen can once again come back. And it's not beyond the bounds of possibility. Well,
away by Rai. Kuma. Bouters right, Roy left. Ball too long. Place in the semi-final at stake. Brazilians have been waiting for success since 1970. In those days they had 3.5 months to prepare and none of their players played his football outside Brazil. Now there are 27 regional championships. There's a national championship of 32 teams and 5 different South American club championships. They play so much football, they're asked so much, but so much is expected of them. Victory chant has gone up again from their supporters.
Well, it has to be the best half of the tournament so far, doesn't it? 5 goals, end-to-end stuff, and I think Holland, you think, can they possibly get another goal back?
You posed the question. I'll ask Terry Venables to answer it.
Well, it suddenly exploded into the classic that we hoped we would get. We've waited so long for it, but now it's opened up and the Dutch have gone forward. And it makes you wonder what would have happened if they'd done that at the beginning. I think there's no doubt about the fact that Bergkamp certainly looks more comfortable, and so does the Dutch team, with him playing deeper. It gives them far more variation. And they look capable of scoring goals in the last 15, 20 minutes. And we must say that Brazil has got out of trouble with a sensational free kick. But at that stage of the game, they never looked like they was going to get into it. I think Overmars has disappointed me in as much as he's not hungry for the ball and they're not feeding him. Now with Bergkamp deeper, he's getting that bit of space and causing Mauro Silva a lot of problems. He can't stay with him. If he can keep feeding Overmars, he's definitely got the beating of Branco. Now, he is the man that can actually cause the trouble that they need.
6 minutes plus stoppage time remaining. Holland 2, Brazil 3. Here's Wim Jonk. Winter. Koeman. Olba Balux in the opposition half. He's got 2 to take on. Shouldn't there be a break by Brazil? Jorginho. Determination to get there first, but he fouled his man. Romario. I think Admirgal encouraging the Brazilians to get on with it. Rai leaves it. Captain's armband has stayed, incidentally, with Dunga. Bollocks.
This half has shown that the Brazilian defence perhaps isn't quite as secure as we thought in the early part of the tournament. And one question mark still, I think, remains over the goalkeeper, Taffarel, who has done nothing to suggest he is any better, perhaps, than some of the Brazilian goalkeepers we've seen in past tournaments.
86 minutes of the match. Holland trying to force the contest into extra time. Bebeto, one of the Brazilian scorers. Bergkamp. Between Overmars and De Boer. Koeman. Pitched to his left. Roy further forward. De Boer in the van at the front. Well won. Marcio Santos. Jan Valters has to go back to collect. Won't expect to play for his country again unless they can save themselves here. Fallux. Every Brazilian has dropped back behind the ball, including Romario. Bichka. It's away from Rai, doesn't make a good challenge until rather late. Bergkamp didn't look to see that Overmars had come in, which Overmars probably shouldn't have. Wouters is behind. Winter collects. This is Wouters. Just wanted to hold it in. the advantage. Franco gives it away. Overmars. Out comes Mauro Silva. Free kick against Dennis Bergkamp.
But there were three times Mark Overmars got the ball then. Every occasion he came inside. He's never tried to go outside Renko, and with his pace, what he's got to do, he hasn't actually got a dribble pass, he's just got to knock it 10 yards and accelerate.
It's very difficult to understand because Renko has none of the pace of Terry Phelan, who didn't enjoy playing against him, or indeed the England defence at Wembley, who didn't enjoy playing against him.
They just clipped the heel of Mauro Silva, who's had another excellent game, but definitely Overmars, when you remember how well he played against Ireland, has been a huge disappointment. And poor old Brian Roy is still waiting to get into the game down the left, isn't he?
The yellow card is shown, seemingly to Jan Baltus. Second Dutchman booked. Long delay in removing Mauro Silva. This is Cafu. Came on against the United States when, although they were down to 10 men when Leonardo was sent off, he was the only substitute used by Carlos Alberto Pereira. Well, they celebrated once too early. Still not all over.
The second substitution.
And Branco was about to be withdrawn for Cafu coming on, but Carlos Alberto Pereira comes and pulls the boards down and changes his mind. That's because he's not sure of the condition of Mauro Silva, I suspect. Mauro Silva now waiting to be invited back. The referee says, no, we're going to play on. I'm having none of this nonsense. Hit long for Romario. Bebeto. Romario! The most theatrical dive yet by the Brazilians, and we've seen a few of them. Referee waves away, and out come Holland with Bergkamp. Serve them right if they got caught here. Not a good ball to Roy.
Looked so threatening there, didn't it? Four men up. This is the penalty incident, just falling over. Bautas and Romario looking for the penalty at a late stage in the game.
A substitution will be made just to take away the Dutch rhythm, which they had until Branco won the free kick. Comes off looking as though he's injured. I have to tell you, he walks like that most of the time. He gets great applause from the Brazilian following. Handshakes all around. He thinks he scored the winner. Holland still have the chance to make him think again. Jorginho. Palux has to improvise as he got ahead of his man. Just knocked out of play by Mauro Silva. There's quite a lot of stoppage time the referee should be allowing here. We're coming to the end of the first minute of it. This is Bergkamp. Again, the pass doesn't quite find its man. And Dunga just bangs the ball away. Throw to De Huy. It's got to be not long. De Boer gets a bit of it, but not enough. Cafu shows his versatility. Wanted to get forward and then remembers the position. Romario is offside. That time he knew it. Dutch in front of me, standing on their seats and praying. It's not long enough for Palux. Offside, in fact, against the defender who got forward.
As a second stick away, we've seen both sides of this Brazilian team, haven't we? The flair, the exciting attacking play, suddenly the uncertainty when they concede a goal. It allowed Holland to get all square. The game almost seemed to be slipping away from them. And then suddenly they conjure up another piece of brilliance and go ahead again.
Also seeing both sides of the Dutch team. And sadly for them, they came the wrong way around. Didn't go out to win the match. And they're going to end up probably by paying the penalty, but it's still not certain. Here's Jonk. Does well to get it to Vitsca. Five forward. Tafarel comes to meet the ball, claims it well. Referee says that De Boer made a back for him. Positive goalkeeping this time by Tafarel. Koeman. Vitsca. Bergkamp just jumped at his man. He wasn't going to get the ball. Overmars. Back to Winter. Goal gave such hope. Doesn't reach De Boer. Chased back by Roy. Square is Koeman. Further over is Wim Jonk. The old man Wouters comes into it. Tries to play it early. Doesn't play it well. Taken by Cafu, but it came off his hand.
Surely the last chance for Holland this.
Seven players in attacking positions. Koeman is just to the right, but it's going to be played in by Jonk. Bergkamp doesn't even get off the ground. Vitsca. Mara Silva just wants to knock it long. Just did enough then to force Overmars to play it back to his goalkeeper. Brazilians in the crowd want the final whistle. They've all moved up. The linesman waving on the far side for offside. It's not the final whistle. It's quite a reaction of the crowd. I don't stand it on the bench. They want to celebrate. Dutch all sitting down. Brazilians seconds away from the semi-final in a match they won, then nearly lost, and saved themselves with a free kick. Here's Romario. Romario took it away from the shot. Absolutely no doubt that the match was going Holland's way until that free kick by Branca. Another look at the watch. Referee looks at it determinedly, but they're not going to persuade him. Only he is going to make the final decision. And he's had a good match. The Dutch saying to him, allow more stoppage time.
The Brazilian drums certainly woke us up about 7 o'clock this morning in our hotel, and I've got a feeling they might keep us awake this evening as well.
And the final whistle is blown, and Brazil go through to the semi-finals. Holland, sad to say, only had themselves to blame. They came back magnificently from two goals down. But Branco is the star in the Lone Star State. He took Brazil to the last ball.
Well, we said it had potential, and it potentialed.
You did see it was going to be a classic in the second half.
Indeed, they are.